The US Air Force said that a successful test of the air-launched rapid response weapon, hypersonic missile, has been conducted. The release said on Monday, a US Air Force B-52H Stratofortress successfully released an AGM-183A air-launched rapid response weapon, or ARRW, off the Southern California coast May 14. The B-52H Stratofortress that launched the missile was from the 419th Flight Test Squadron. After the separation from the aircraft, the ARRW's booster ignited and burned for the expected duration, achieving hypersonic speeds 5 times greater than the speed of sound. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the successful launch of ARRW from the B-52 bomber is a key development. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles, from the 1930s to the 1990s, and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Brigadier General Heath Collins, USAF Program Executive Officer for Weapons, said, "This was a major accomplishment by the ARRW team for the weapons enterprise and our Air Force." He added, "The team's tenacity, expertise, and commitment were key in overcoming the past year's challenges to get us to the recent success. We are ready to build on what we've learned and continue moving hypersonics forward." The challenges that Collins referred to are the 3 failed attempts before this. In the first and third instances, the prototype AGM-183As did not even leave the wing of the B-52H bomber carrying them. On the second test, the missile had separated, but the rocket booster did not ignite, and the prototype fell into the Pacific. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed the speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. Extreme speed of hypersonic weapons and ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a much higher probability of penetrating modern air defenses. They'll be very hard to track, let alone intercept. It's to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles also reach hypersonic speeds when they descend down on the target, but they follow a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which leaves scope for interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. In 2017, Lockheed Martin won the contract to begin ARRW development. The company had stated it wanted to meet the desired production targets within 3 years. Will Roper, the Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology, and Logistics, had said in a statement about the flight test, "We set out an aggressive schedule with ARRW. Getting to this flight test on time highlights the amazing work of our acquisition workforce and our partnership with Lockheed Martin and other industry partners." He had added, "We're using the rapid prototyping authorities provided by Congress to quickly bring hypersonic weapon capabilities to the warfighter. This type of speed in our acquisition system is essential. It allows us to field capabilities rapidly to compete against the threats we face." There are different types of hypersonic weapons. ARRW is essentially a hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, or an aircraft where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere, and then glides back, attaining hypersonic speed. The Boeing B-52 Stratofortress is a long-range, subsonic, jet-powered strategic bomber in service with the U.S. Air Force. The B-52 was designed and built by Boeing, which has continued to provide support and upgrades. It's been operated by the United States Air Force since the 1950s and with upgrades is supposed to serve into the 2040s. It has a typical combat range of more than 8,800 miles or 14,080 kilometers without aerial refueling. The massive range enables B-52 to take on strategic bombing missions. The powerful engines also enable B-52 to carry up to 70,000 pounds or 32,000 kilograms of weapons. Depending on the exact size of the aero, B-52 may be one of the only few aircraft that will be able to carry it. B-52 is currently a vulnerable platform because of its large radar cross-section and relatively slow speed. It will find it difficult to penetrate the advanced air defense system. But with aero, it will have a weapon that can be launched from standoff distances without getting inside the engagement envelope of enemy air defenses. The U.S. is lagging in the hypersonic weapons space, especially against Russia and China. Russia has already fielded Avangard and Kinzhal, whereas China has deployed Chinese DFZF and YJ-21. As stated by U.S. DoD leaders, hypersonic weapons are a national imperative. Michael E. White, Principal Director for Hypersonics, has said the adversaries have increasingly focused on systems that dramatically compress the timelines and the time scale of a tactical battlefield. He indicated that American portfolio of subsonic and supersonic weapons will be found wanting in a battle. He stated that the U.S. Department of Defense has developed the hypersonics modernization strategy that accelerates the development and delivery of transformational warfighting capabilities based on hypersonic systems. In this situation, the successful test of aero is a major boost for U.S. forces.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.